वेलकम टू द लेक्चर ऑन ब्लॉक मेसनरी एंड फॉर्मवर्क। दिस इज द यूनिट नंबर 2। इन द प्रीवियस यूनिट वी हैव डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग ब्रिक मेसनरी एंड स्टोन मेसनरी। सो अंडर दिस यूनिट नंबर 2 पार्ट ए इज ब्लॉक मेसनरी। दिस ब्लॉक मेसनरी इज सब डिवाइडेड इंटू ब्लॉक मेसनरी सेल, कैविटी वॉल कंस्ट्रक्शन, पार्टीशन वॉल्स एंड कंपोजिट मेसनरी। The objectives of this lecture are to study the cellular lightweight blocks, to demonstrate concept of hollow and solid concrete blocks. Types of masonry concrete blocks are cellular lightweight concrete blocks, hollow concrete blocks and solid concrete blocks. Cellular lightweight concrete blocks, it is abbreviated as CLC. Cellular lightweight concrete block is foam concrete, also known as low density cellular concrete LDCC. Low density cellular concrete LDCC. The cellular lightweight concrete blocks widely used for construction purposes, and it has various advantages and uses than the traditional concrete bricks. Foam concrete is manufactured by mixing of Portland cement, sand, fly ash, water, along with some foaming agent. So foaming agent, shampoo is also one type of foaming agent which is used for preparation of these CLC, cellular lightweight concrete blocks. CLC can be produced at building site using machines and molds devised for normal concrete at in situ conditions, where conditions may or may not be favorable, may not be supportive. In that situation, one can prepare this cellular lightweight concrete blocks. The density of this poor concrete usually varies from 400 kg per meter cube to 1600 kg per meter cube. Now we'll discuss constituents of cellular lightweight concrete blocks. That is, constituents are nothing but ingredients or the materials, various materials which are required for manufacturing of this cellular lightweight concrete blocks. So important constituents of cellular lightweight concrete blocks are, number one is foam, then fly ash, and last is cement. So the foam is generated from foam generator, and it produces stable foam by using an appropriate foaming agent. The air content is maintained at 40 to 80% of the total volume. Whatever volume is prepared, out of that volume, 40 to 80% volume is of the size of the bubble differ from 0.1 mm to 1.5 mm in diameter. Here in this sketch, you can say this is a cellular lightweight concrete. Here you will find the pores. These pores are due to air only or due to foaming agent only. Here you can see the bigger view, zoom view of the cellular concrete. Next agent is ingredient is fly ash. Fly ash is generally a waste product from industries. Normally, whatever waste product is generated from thermal power plant, it is nothing but it is fly ash. In our area at Eklare power station, thermal power plant, you will find this type of fly ash, waste from industry. The major issue with these thermal power plants is to dispose of this fly ash, because this fly ash cannot be used for other purposes. In fact, it is a waste and it is in large amount. Since fly ash is one of the key ingredients of cellular lightweight concrete, it dissolves the issue of its disposal, and at the same time it's very economical. It makes foam concrete as environment friendly. It makes environment friendly concrete as a environment friendly. Now next is cement. In fact, cement is used as a binding agent. Cellular lightweight concrete is a homogeneous combination of Portland cement, cement silica, cement pozzolana, lime silica paste. All have same cell structure, and it is obtained from gas forming chemicals or foaming agents at measured levels. So normally for manufacturing of this cellular lightweight concrete block, the pozzolana cement is used. Portland cement is also used. Now coming to advantages of cellular lightweight concrete blocks, it has various advantages depending upon their applications. Number one is it is lightweight, it is fire resistant, it has having thermal insulation, it is soundproof, acoustical insulation, it is environment friendly, it is cost effective, it is termite free. So number one is lightweight. CLC is lightweight, which helps in weight management of building material and craning work. It reduces the craning work. Fire resistance, the air pocket in the structure are mainly responsible for high fire resistance. The high density of CLC walls can last for hours in fire. Then thermal insulation, the low density foam concrete is perfect for thermal insulation. At this density, it has a density that supports structure. Sound absorption and acoustical insulation, low density increases acoustical insulation, it is soundproof, environment friendly. Low weight fly ash concrete blocks uses an industrial waste, so obviously it will be environment friendly. In other words, it will reduce the problem of dumping of the fly ash. It is cost effective as it uses the industrial waste, so obviously it will reduce the production cost and in turn it will become economical. Construction cost will be less with compared to normal construction cost. It is termite free and resistant freezing issue. Silver lightweight concrete is termite proof and resistant to freezing issues. Now coming to applications of the CLC, where the CLC silver lightweight concrete blocks are used. So CLC is preferable for thermal insulation as bricks and blocks instead of flat roofs and non-loading ones. The low strength material is used for old sewer pipes. It is also used for sewer pipes, wells, unused cellars and basement storage tanks, tunnels and subways. It is also used to build a heat insulated light well panel. It maintains the acoustical balance of concrete. So in the concrete, wherever acoustical effect is required, the cellular lightweight concrete blocks are used. It is used in light heat resistant ceramic tiles also. It is useful in case of soil water drainage purposes, where drainage is a must. In case of this, cellular lightweight concrete is used, and with the help of that cellular hole, small holes, drainage is possible. Concrete blocks. Now next is concrete blocks. So concrete block masonry, which is also known as concrete masonry unit, have advantages over the brick and stone masonry. Concrete blocks are manufactured required shape and sizes, and this may be solid or hollow blocks. The common size, the sizes in which the concrete blocks are manufactured are 39 by 19 centimeter. The length is 39 centimeter, the width is 19 centimeter, and the thickness, it is produced depending upon the wall thickness. So maximum is 30 centimeter, then maybe of 20 centimeter and 10 centimeter. In terms of inches, it may be 4 inch, 6 inch and 8 inch, 10 inch, 12 inch with configuration. For manufacturing of these cement concrete blocks, cement aggregate water is used to prepare this. The cement aggregate ratio in concrete block is 1:6, means one part of cement and six parts of aggregate. Again, under the six parts, aggregate use is of 60%, means 40% is cement and 60% in case of aggregate, 60% fine aggregate and 40% coarse aggregate is used. So this aggregate, six parts of aggregate is combination of fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. The coarse 60% fine aggregate use and 40% coarse aggregate use. Their minimum strength is about 3 newton per mm square. So already we have discussed under this concrete, two types of concrete blocks are there: solid concrete blocks and hollow concrete blocks. Solid concrete blocks are commonly used, which are heavy in weight and manufactured from dense aggregate. They are very strong and provides good stability to the structures. So for large work of masonry, like for load bearing walls, these solid concrete blocks are preferred. Wherever structure is a load bearing structure, solid concrete blocks are used. They are available in large sizes. Already we have discussed sizes 39 by 19 by 30 centimeter. 39 by 19 is common, length is 39, width is 19, and depth may be 30 centimeter, it may be 20 centimeter, and it may be 10 centimeter are used in a masonry work. Now coming to hollow concrete blocks. So in case of these hollow concrete blocks, hollows are provided hollow concrete blocks contains wide area greater than 25% of gross area. So here this hollow area, it should be minimum 25%. So here in case of this hollow concrete blocks, solid area of hollow concrete block should be more than 50%. So you can say 50% may be solid, 50% may be hollow. The hollow part may be divided into several components based on our requirement. So there may be two hollows, three hollows, depending upon the requirement. They are manufactured from lightweight aggregate. They are lightweight blocks and easy to install. So in case of these lightweight concrete blocks, here in this you can see two hollows are provided. This is called as a rib. The minimum, this part between two hollows, that is called as rib, and it should be minimum 5 cm. Similar to solid concrete blocks, or in general you can say the sizes of blocks are maybe solid, maybe hollow, 39 by 19 by 30, 39 by 19 by 20, and 39 by 19 by 10 cm, in terms of centimeter. So under these hollow concrete blocks, there are various types. Stretcher blocks are there, corner blocks are there, pillar blocks are there, jam block, partition block, lintel block, frogged brick block, and last is bull's nose block. At this juncture, we shall discuss only few types. So very first is concrete stretcher block. As it is used along the length, so it is called as stretcher block. Concrete stretcher blocks are used to join the corner in the masonry. Stretcher blocks are widely used concrete hollow block in construction. They are laid with their length parallel to the face of wall. So in case of this, they are like, they are arranged in such a way that this long length or length will be parallel to the face of wall. Next is concrete corner block. Concrete corner blocks are used at the ends of corners of masonry. The ends may be window or door openings, etc. They are arranged in a manner that their plain end visible to the outside and the other end is locked with the stretcher block. So plain end, in case of this one end, this end will be plain, and in case of this end, locking arrangement is provided at the corner. So this is concrete corner block. And last is concrete pillar block. The pillar block is also called as double corner block. So from both the ends can be used. Here no locking arrangement is provided. Generally these are used when two ends of the corners are visible. Both ends are visible. In that case, these corner blocks are used. In case of piers or pillars, these blocks are widely used. So this is all about cellular concrete blocks, solid concrete blocks, and hollow concrete blocks. Thank you.